And now to our exclusive with ESPN anchor Molly Karam, opening up about her private health battle with endometriosis. It's a serious condition millions of American women face. It's responsible for half of infertility cases in women. And for Molly, it included pain so severe she couldn't get out of bed for days at a time.
We have a huge show today. We're really fired up.
On ESPN's First Take, co-host Molly Karam brings her A-game to the roundtable.
Did you talk about that a lot?
Dishing on the day's hottest news in sports.
Did the Cavs make the right moves?
But behind the camera, the 33-year-old silently struggles with endometriosis. She was first diagnosed 7 years ago.
The endometriosis was not just in my reproductive organs. It was everywhere, on my liver, on my intestines. And essentially why I had that horrific pain was it had like all compiled into a cyst, which burst, and then the toxins were all in my body.
An estimated 1 out of 10 American women have endometriosis, a condition where tissue that normally grows inside the uterus is found outside it, causing immense abdominal cramping and sometimes infertility. There is no known cure, but can be managed with treatment.
Tell me what your options were at that point.
I was put on Lupron, so I was getting injections into my backside, which was awesome. Pain's just running down your leg. And it put my body into menopause. I gained a lot of weight, and I didn't feel myself mentally, emotionally, physically.
Acupuncture has become a huge source of relief for you.
Acupuncture has been a saving grace.
So I'm gonna feel your pulse.
Molly, focusing on self-care, turned to the traditional Chinese medicine to ease her discomfort.
The ones on her feet kind of deal with the hormonal imbalances that she might have due to the endometriosis, and then the ones on her stomach too, that's for the pain.
Revamping her diet also made a huge difference.
My version of soda, seltzer water.
I'm a huge fan.
Cutting out all sugar, alcohol, and processed foods, but her one vice, caffeine.
However, haven't kicked that habit just yet, but I'm on in the
I know, believe me. I have 3 cups a day of coffee. Yeah.
Molly hopes by telling her story, it can drive awareness to much needed research.
If I can connect with some other people and help them feel like they're not alone, we can fight through this, and then hopefully in the next couple of generations, you know, they're gonna have the right treatments and this will no longer be an issue.
And again, there's no cure for endometriosis, and so doctors treat it on an individualized basis on symptoms or whether or not a woman's trying to get pregnant or not.
And so many people just are not aware of the severity of this.
No, and Molly herself was not aware of it until it happened to her, and so she wants to make women know. This is something that happens to 1 out of 10 women, and oftentimes hysterectomy is what it can lead to, and that's such a dramatic event for any woman, and so she wants to find and help doctors find other ways to give some relief to women without taking that drastic measure.
Good that she's found some ways to do that and that she's sharing her story. All right, Amy.